Very good morning, students. Already yesterday, we started discussing about the electric dipole. What do you mean by this electric dipole? As we discussed, if two equal and unlike charges, equal in the sense, equal in magnitude, unlike means, opposite nature. If two equal and unlike charges are separated by a certain distance, then it is called as electric dipole. As for our convenience, simply we call it as a dipole. The important parameter here in case of dipole is dipole moment. These are all yesterday we discussed. Dipole moment is equal to q into 2l. So the dipole moment is a vector quantity. It will be always represented with the symbol p. So the magnitude of the dipole moment is product of charge and distance between those two, and its direction will be, the direction of dipole moment will be always from negative charge to positive charge. So in this direction the dipole moment will act. The unit of the dipole moment is, the unit of charge is coulomb, the unit of length is meter. Coulomb meter is the unit of dipole moment, and its dimensional formula is ATL. The dimensional formula for the charge is AT, and the dimensional formula for meter, meter indicates your length, the dimensional formula for the length is L. Now if I consider the electric dipole as one system now, then what will be the net charge of an electric dipole? What will be the net charge of an electric dipole? The net charge of an electric dipole is zero, because as we know, the charges are additive in nature. If I add minus q and plus q, we are going to get a zero value. So as a dipole, if you consider as a single system, the net charge of a dipole is zero. But in previous classes, we discussed that whenever the charge is there, then only the electric field will exist. As far as this dipole is concerned, here the net charge is zero. Since the charge is zero, as per previous classes, it should not produce any electric field. But here, that is the wrong conception or misconception. Here what will happen is, since these two charges are separated by a certain distance, definitely it will produce us some electric field. Why? Because these two charges are separated by a certain distance. Now, how much electric field? What is the formula to find out the electric field produced by the dipole? So here two cases are there. Those two cases are very, 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 very important for 5 marks as per PUC is concerned. Put a heading. The electric field at any point, the electric field at any point on the axial line, of an electric dipole. The electric field at any point on the axial line of an electric dipole. Now, I am considering a beautiful electric dipole. This is minus q and this is plus q, separated by a distance 2L. Now I want to find out the electric field because of this electric dipole at any point on the axial line, on its axial line. Axial line is nothing but the line joining the centers of the two charges. So this is called as an axial line. on the axial line, I am taking a point P. That point P is at a distance of R from the center of an electric dipole. That point P is at a distance of R from the center of an electric dipole. Then here, how many electric fields will act here? Two electric fields will act at the point P. One is because of plus Q, other is because of the minus Q. Because of the plus Q, what will be the electric field and what is its direction? Here, as I said earlier, whenever you want to find the electric intensity at any point, at that point, we need to imagine one unit positive charge. So here I am imagining one unit positive charge here at the point P. Now this is positive and this is positive. So the direction of electric intensity will be like this. A1. No doubt. Let E1 be the electric intensity. Let E1 be the electric intensity acting at point P. Due to charge plus Q. Then, so whenever you want to find the electric intensity because of one single charge, what is the formula? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What is the charge we have? Q we have. And the distance between these two. So here, because of it is the center point of an electric dipole, so this will be the L. And this is also L. Now I want to the distance between, for example, if I call it as an A, B, I want BP value now. Since I want BP value, so this is R and this is L. So this will be R minus L whole square. So E1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R minus L whole square. Similarly, because of the charge minus Q, one more electric intensity will act at point P. So this is negative and this is positive. Then the direction of electric intensity will be like this. E2. Let E2 be the electric intensity acting at point P. Due to the charge minus Q. So because of the charge minus Q, what will be the electric intensity at P? So again, E2 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Here charge is minus Q. What I said, though it is minus Q, we have to take plus Q only. Why? Because already we used the minus symbol in terms of direction. So again, not necessary to use that minus symbol. So now the distance between A and P. So from here to here L, from here to here R. So we are going to get R plus L होल स्क्वायर, आर प्लस एल होल स्क्वायर. नेक्स्ट वन, हियर एट पी हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रिक इंटेंसिटीज आर एक्टिंग. टू इलेक्ट्रिक इंटेंसिटीज आर एक्टिंग, वन इज ई वन एंड वन इज ई टू. मोर ओवर those two are acting in opposite direction. E1 and E2 are acting in opposite direction. Then what will be the resultant of, what will be the resultant of those two now? So since both are acting in opposite direction, the resultant we can get by taking the difference of those two, E1 difference E2, by taking the difference of those two. So here difference is nothing but what? What is the difference between difference and subtraction? Will it both are same or differ? Will it both are same or differ? In case of difference, we'll go with bigger minus smaller always. So based on that, among E1 and E2, which one is bigger and which one is smaller? Between E1 and E2, which one is bigger and which one is smaller? So if I see these formulas, here the denominator is more, so definitely E2 will be lesser than E1. Then what is the resultant electric intensity? Now E is equal to E1 minus E2, because E1 is greater than, because E1 is greater than E2. So what is E1 value? Idi. What is E2 value? Idi. Now E1 is equal to 1/4πε0 q/r-l whole square minus 1/4πε0 q/r+l whole square. If I take a common of 1/4πε0 q, if I take a common of this, we are going to have 1/r-l whole square minus 1/r+l whole square. 1/4πε0 q, if I take a common, 1/r-l whole square minus 1/r+l whole square. Then you go with an LCM. If I go with an LCM, 1/4πε0 q r+l whole square minus r-l whole square divided by r-l whole square into r+l whole square. So 1/4πε0 q into r+l whole square minus r-l whole square by r-l whole square into r+l whole square. Okay. Now if you further simplify that, E is equal to 1/4πε0 q. This is in the form of a+b whole square minus a-b whole square. a+b whole square minus a-b whole square. We are going to have, what we are going to have? a² + b² + 2ab. Minus a square minus b square minus into minus plus 2ab. We are going to have 4ab. 4, a is nothing but r, b is nothing but l, divided by, this is a-b into a+b whole square. So a-b into a+b, a² - b². So we are going to have r² - l² whole square. So this I will write for my convenience 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 into here Q is there. Q into here already 2 I took. So remaining 2L. Q into 2L into R by R square minus L square whole square. Q into 2L. The product of charge and the distance or the length of the dipole will give the dipole moment. Now, the electric intensity E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q into 2L is P. Q into 2L is P. So we are going to have 2 PR divided by R square minus L square whole square. So this is the formula to find out the electric intensity at any point on the axial line of an electric dipole. Then as we know, the electric intensity is a vector quantity. Since it is a vector quantity, it should have both magnitude and direction. Here we got the magnitude. Then what about its direction? What about its direction? Here, since E1 and E2 are acting in opposite direction, the direction of the resultant will be same as that of the bigger one. The direction of the resultant is the same as that of the bigger one. So the direction of resultant electric field at the point P now will be the same direction as that of E1. So what is the direction of E1? As I said earlier, the direction of the dipole moment is from negative charge to positive charge. So the direction of the E1 is also same as that of the direction of the dipole moment. The direction of resultant will be also same as that of the direction of the dipole moment. So the direction of electric intensity will be always same as that of the direction of the dipole moment. If you want to express the same thing in a vector form, E bar is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 P bar R divided by R square minus L square whole square. So this is the final formula to find out the resultant electric intensity. At any point on the axial line of an electric dipole. If I take a short dipole, what do you mean by the short dipole? If the length of the dipole, that is 2L value, is smaller than R. If the 2L value is very, 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 very small, such a dipole we call it as a short dipole. In case of the short dipole, that is, if 2L value is lesser than R, if 2L value is very, 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 very small compared to R, obviously the L value will be further small. Since the value of L is very, 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 very small compared to R, we can ignore the value of L. When it is compared with R, that is important. Since the value of L is very, 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 very small compared to R, we can ignore the value of L when it is compared with R. That is nothing but comparison is nothing but
either if you do the addition or subtraction, then we can ignore the value of L. So I can take the value of L as 0 now. If I take that, then we are going to have E bar is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 P bar into R by L value has to be considered as a 0 now. Then R square whole square, which is equal to R to the power of 4. When it is R to the power of 4, numerator 1R is there. 1R and 1R get cancelled here. So the final electric intensity at any point on the axial line of a short electric dipole, E bar is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 P by R cube. So this formula will be used if and only if the electric dipole is a short dipole. Whereas in normal condition, we have to follow this formula. So what is the direction of electric field at any point on the axial line of an electric dipole is the direction of resultant electric field will be same as that of the direction of the dipole moment. What is the direction of dipole moment? The direction of dipole moment will be always from negative charge to positive charge. This derivation is very, very, very important for 5 marks as for PUC is concerned. Right? Next, one more important derivation for 5 marks, that is, put a heading. Electric intensity at any point on the equatorial line, at any point on the equatorial line of an electric dipole, the electric intensity at any point on the equatorial line of an electric dipole. This derivation is also very important for 5 marks. Generally, he will ask either one of this derivation for 5 marks as PUC is concerned. So here is also, I am considering an electric dipole. That too. Here I am considering a beautiful electric dipole. Electric dipole is nothing but two equal and unlike charges are separated by a certain distance called as a 2L. Now what do you mean by this equatorial line? Equatorial line is nothing but it is a perpendicular bisecting line. So I am considering a perpendicular bisector. This perpendicular bisecting line only we call it as an equatorial line. So exactly it is at the center because it is a perpendicular bisector. Now this will be L and this will be also L. Now I am choosing the point, very good. I am choosing the point P on the equatorial line, which is at a distance of R from the center of an electric dipole. which is at a distance of r from the center of an electric dipole. Now I would like to find what is the resultant electric intensity acting at this point P. Here, how many electric intensities will act? As usual, two electric intensities will act at this point because of two charges are there. Because of the charge plus Q, one electric intensity. Because of the charge minus Q, one more electric intensity. Okay. Now, as we know, whenever or wherever you want to find the electric intensity, there we need to imagine one unit positive charge. So I am imagining one unit positive charge at the point P. Now this is P, that is, this is positive and this is also positive. Obviously, there will be a repulsive electric intensity. Repulsive electric intensity is nothing but, it will be like this. What is even now? Even is the electric intensity acting at point P due to the charge plus Q. No doubt. Let E1 be the electric intensity acting at the point P. Electric intensity acting at the point P due to charge plus Q. Now what is that formula? E1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What is the charge here? Q. And the distance between these two. Distance between E distance. This distance we have to consider. So we don't know how much it is. So for my convenience, I am considering it as an A. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by A square. Similarly, because of this minus Q, one more electric intensity will act at point P. Because of the minus Q, one more electric intensity will act at the point P. So that electric intensity, I am calling it as an E2. Note on. Let E2 be the electric intensity. Let E2 be the electric intensity acting at the point P. Let E2 be the electric intensity acting at the point P due to the charge minus Q. Let E2 be the electric intensity acting at the point P due to the charge minus Q. Now this is positive and this is negative. Obviously, the direction of electric intensity will be like this. The direction of electric intensity will be like this. This I am calling it as an E2. Then what is the formula to find out E2 value? E2 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Here the charge is minus Q. Though here minus Q is there, already I said many times, we have to take positive only Q. And definitely if this distance is A, obviously this distance will be also A. So Q by A square. By seeing these two equations, even I can say that the E1 is equal to E2. By seeing those two equations, we come to know E1 is equal to E2. So at P, two electric fields are acting. One is E1, other one is E2. Moreover, those two are neither acting in same direction nor acting in opposite direction. So both are not acting neither in same nor in opposite. So these two are separated by a certain angle. Whenever two vectors are separated by a certain angle, in order to get the resultant, we need to construct a beautiful parallelogram. So this is one parallelogram what I am considering. So if two sides represent two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, or two vectors represents two adjacent sides of a parallelogram, then the diagonal of the parallelogram will give the resultant of those two. So here, this is the resultant now. Resultant of E1 and E2 will act along the diagonal of a parallelogram. That I am calling it as an E. What is E here? E is the resultant of E1 and E2. Now, we don't know the angle between E1 and E2. So for that, for my convenience, I am taking the total angle is 2 theta. If you take 2 theta, here theta will get. I am taking 2 theta. So the angle between E1 and E2 is 2 theta. If the total angle is 2 theta, this is theta and this will be also theta. Otherwise, I am considering this angle as theta. Obviously, this angle will be also same. So theta, theta, 2 theta. Then the angle between E1 and E2 now becomes 2 theta. Then what is the formula to find out the resultant by using the parallelogram? E is equal to E1 square plus E2 square plus 2E1E2 cos theta. Theta is the angle between E1 and E2 actually in the formula. But here this angle is 2 theta. Under root. We know that E1 is equal to E2. So based on that, I will put one more step. E1 square plus E1 square plus 2E1 square cos 2 theta under root. I am substituting E1 instead of E2. So E1 square plus E1 square, 2E1 square plus 2E1 square cos 2 theta under root. If I take a common of 2E1 square, we'll get 1 plus cos 2 theta. So, as we know, 1 plus cos theta formula, 2 cos square theta by 2. In the same manner, 1 plus cos 2 theta formula, 2 cos square theta. So, 2E1 square into 2 cos square theta under root. 2 into 2, 4. If you bring the 4 out of the root, we are going to get 2. E1 square root E1 cos square theta root cos theta. So the net electric field acting at the point P now 2E1 cos theta. Now, as we know, if this angle is theta, this angle will be also theta. If this angle is theta, this angle will be also theta. Now, you substitute the values.
E is equal to 2 even value 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by A square.
Then what about this cos theta value? What about this cos theta value? This is theta. Cos theta is nothing but adjacent side by hypotenuse, where the adjacent side is L, hypotenuse is A. So we are going to have here L by A. Very good. Then it will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 2L divided by A cube. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 2L divided by A cube. But we don't want the formula in terms of A, because we are finding electric intensity at a distance r. So final formula I need to get in terms of r, not in terms of A. So if I take this right angled triangle, if you apply a Pythagoras theorem, A square is equal to r square plus l square, if you apply a Pythagoras theorem, then I am considering A as square root of r square plus l square. Now this will be equal to E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 2L. The charge into the length of the dipole will give the dipole moment P by A is nothing but r square plus l square under root. So we are going to have r square plus l square whole to the power of 3 by 2. E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by r square plus l square whole to the power of 3 by 2. So this is the formula to find out the electric intensity at any point on the equatorial line of an electric dipole. Since electric intensity is a vector quantity, it will have both magnitude and direction. By using this formula, we are getting the magnitude. What about its direction? What about its direction? See here, the direction of resultant electric intensity will be like this. What is the direction of dipole moment? Is always from negative charge to positive charge. So the direction of the dipole moment is like this. The direction of electric field is like this. Then what is the direction of electric field? We can say the direction of electric field is parallel to the dipole moment, but in opposite direction. Why? Because the direction of the dipole moment is from negative to positive. Here the resultant electric intensity we got from positive to negative, E direction. Dipole moment direction is E direction we got. So, no doubt, the direction of electric field, the direction of electric field is parallel and opposite direction is parallel and opposite direction is parallel and opposite direction to the direction of dipole moment. The same thing, if you want to put it in a vector form, E bar is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P bar by r square plus l square whole to the power of 3 by 2 we can write. But here the direction of dipole moment is opposite to this. So I will put one minus symbol here. E bar is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus P bar by r square plus l square whole to the power of 3/2. Okay. If I go with a short dipole, short dipole is nothing but what? If the length of the dipole is very, 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 very small, that dipole we call it as a short dipole. So I will consider if 2L is lesser than R, that implies that the value of 2L is very small when compared with R. If the value of 2L is very small, the value of L will be further small compared with R. So obviously we can ignore the value of L when it is compared with R. When, if and only if, the value of L is much smaller than R, then E is equal to 1/4πε₀ P divided by L value we can ignore now. So R square whole to the power of 3/2. Now E is equal to 1/4πε₀ P by, here 2 and 2 get cancels. The remaining is only R cube. So this is the formula to find out the electric intensity at any point on the equatorial line of a short electric dipole. This formula will be used only in case of short dipole. What do you mean by the short dipole? If the length of the dipole is very, 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 very small. So these two derivations, what I derived today, is very, 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 very important for 5 marks as for PUC is concerned. Now, note. Note. What is the first formula we derived now? We derived today. E axial is equal to, that is, electric intensity at any point on the axial line. E axial is equal to 1/4πε₀ 2P by R cube. This is the formula what we derived today. So that too, it is a short dipole. Generally we'll consider always short dipoles only until and unless he mentioned it as a long dipole. Otherwise in all the cases, as a default, we'll consider short dipoles only. Second formula what we derived today, E equatorial. What do we mean by E equatorial? The electric intensity at any point on the equatorial line, E equatorial is equal to 1/4πε₀ P by R cube. P by R cube. From these two, we can obtain a relation now. E axial is equal to 2 times of E equatorial. The electric intensity at any point on the axial line is equal to twice the electric intensity at any point on the equatorial line. Next, fourth one. If I take a single charge, and instead of dipole, if I take an isolated charge, single charge or point charge, then how the electric intensity related with the distance in such a case? So what is the formula for electric intensity in case of a single charge? E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Andre, in case of the single charge, the electric intensity is inversely proportional to r square. Electric intensity is inversely proportional to r square. Whereas today what we derived, in case of a dipole, in case of a dipole, either you go with an axial line or equatorial line. So in the denominator, we have an r cube, not r square. R cube we got. So in case of an electric dipole, electric intensity is inversely proportional to r cube. E is inversely proportional to r cube. In case of an electric dipole, E is inversely proportional to r square. In case of a single charge or the point charge or the isolated charge, what not you can call. Okay, today we derived two derivations to find electric intensity either on the axial line or on the equatorial line. If the point P is neither on the axial line nor on the equatorial line. So if I consider point P on the axial line, we know how to get the electric intensity. If I consider the point P on the equatorial line, just now we come to know how to get the electric intensity. If the point P is neither on the axial line nor on the equatorial line, then how to get that electric intensity? How to get that electric intensity? Actually, we don't have that derivation as far as PUC is concerned, though we'll derive the derivation on Monday. Okay. Thank you.